The Dope House Live, man. Your player partner, Al Capone. I'm in the building with my man, Rick Jilla. Midwest legend, man. On the what, man?
On the what, nigga? On the what?
And
I read, but on the cool, though, I remember seeing y'all shit, too, like in the Murder Dog and all that
yeah,
shit.
Yeah,
like,
he's in Murder Dog.
West Coast,
yeah.
All of our life. Because, you know, back in the days before you had the internet, man, you really had to seek out the... the shit, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like the shit, and because there was a mainstream, but there was an underground world, man. That
yeah.
That you had to be tapped in with, and Murder yeah. Dog was a platform for, you know, niggas like us. That was what we was from where we from, man. It gave you an opportunity to see, you know, what was going on, and you know, and what they would call the chitlin circuit back then. But
yeah,
you know, the with all the real niggas in the ghettos of America, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And out in the Bay Area, man, it's you know. We take our hip-hop real serious out here.
Yeah.
So, if we, you know, like the Murder Dog was putting us onto a lot of shit, like Midwest, Down South, East Coast. And, you know, as long as cats out here get put onto it, they'll fuck with it.
Yeah, yeah.
If your shit slap, they'll fuck
and
with
now,
it.
The Bay Area was, yeah. The Bay Area was definitely one of the spots where I used to pick up traction at.
Yeah.
The Bay Area and Houston.
Yeah, Houston, Texas.
Yeah, yeah. Which to me was similar because y'all had a very independent... a very independent music scene, which didn't even really need to be outside of this region or this state or whatever, because it was so fucking
right.
big. You know, the market is so big out here and in Houston. So,
how's the market where you from? Is it kind of like that, or is it?
Well, the crazy thing is like the Midwest market is like technically the number one consumer market for hip hop, but like being from the Midwest, like. They don't have access to the outlets to show niggas on TV and the magazines or the main websites and all that. So they don't really look. They don't really respect the
local artists.
Yeah. Because it's not seen on that platform. But in reality, like some of the best music in the world, like a lot of the great music that I heard, them came out of the Midwest and not just Indiana, Chicago. Naptown, Ohio, St. Louis, like it's a pocket of motherfuckers that like really got that shit but just don't have access to the media like the some of the other spots or whatever.
Yeah. Some of the and I'm sure like it is out here, a lot of the bigger artists ain't putting on, the smaller artists ain't.
You know, me and my nigga so busy was talking about it on the way. And I'm sure it's like this in other places, but more so than the Midwest. Like a Midwest nigga that got a little action going on with, he would rather be the main nigga in the room when he in there versus like kind of put the spotlight. Like it's like if I got some shit going on, but I know you dope,
right?
And here you come, like I ain't really trying to like throw you an alley-oop because I know you might do some shit that might
on me.
Yeah. And the average nigga, like the way they made, they ain't really cut like that. And then the gang shit do play a different. Well, niggas got a gang mentality too. It's like if you ain't with my gang, or if we ain't got the same kind of T-shirt or chain, or if we ain't got the same affiliation, niggas ain't really looking out for the. Or what they would consider the ops or whatever. So, but it's a lot of talent out there, and that's why if you really think about it, like when the Midwest artists like just so happen to crack through the, like they really go big.
Right.
If you think about it, like a Kanye, a Nelly, a Eminem, Bone. You know what I mean?
Y'all like, done had some of the biggest in the
history. That's what I'm saying. Michael Jackson, the brat, who
right.
the first female to go.
Yeah.
Like when an artist from the Midwest just so happened to slide through, it's always like really big. But
yeah.
we never really get a wipe to where it's a bunch of us at one time.
Yeah.
That's why we haven't really got a good run like the rest of the. But we got that shit though. History shows, you know, let the record reflect. But, you know, somehow, you know, between niggas' mentality and the way the shit set up, like they don't let enough of us get through at the same time.
And if you trip, the Midwest and the Bay Area is similar circumstances.
Yeah.
The same shit happened out here.
Shit,
a few
shit.
Get on hella big.
Yeah.
But everybody out here talented, but a few get on hella big,
yeah.
and it seems like the rest is held down
yeah.
somehow. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That shit is crazy,
yeah.
man. You
it's
know,
like that though.
Man,
that's why when you're traveling around, you get to really see it's the same shit, like really, like going on just in different, just you know, ain't shit changed but the street names, really, because it's the same shit going on all across this motherfucker, bro.
Man, the Dope House Live, man, in the building with my man Rick Jilla. We'll be back. Dope House Live.
Dope House Live.